Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, I'm actually going to be diving into ClickUp 2. Now this is the second version of the application that they have developed. Now ClickUp has really actually impressed me, I'd say, over the last year because they've been consistently releasing updates and it's this sort of, not all-in-one application, but this really broad project management application. The closest it reminds me of is like monday.com at the moment because they're both very similar applications. But they're doing very well in the market, a lot of people considering them. So in today's video, I'm actually gonna be creating and showing you around ClickUp 2.0, but actually activating to create a content calendar in there so that you can get to see a working way this is created. The other thing I want to mention is if you want to check out the video that Yvonne did diving into it, she's a pretty active user of ClickUp. So obviously she gives us a tour around 2.0, but I want to tour you around this application, giving you my opinions on where I think it's going. Before we begin, guys, a little word from our sponsor, and thanks very much to Sanebox for sponsoring this month on Keep Productive. Do you feel overwhelmed by emails? Then Sanebox might be a handy tool for you. Now, Sanebox helps you to manage emails using artificial intelligence. It'll magically manage your email into a Sane Later folder, which lets you focus on the important stuff in your main inbox. If you find an email in the wrong folder, just move it and it'll learn each time, training your inbox to be smarter and more effective. There's nothing to install, nothing to learn, and the best thing is that it works with any email service you already use. I currently use it with Missive. Now, we've had Sanebox on before as a sponsor, and they are back again. This is one of the tools I paid for on a monthly basis and can't recommend trying it enough. I actually upgraded to their annual plan back in July. You guys can get a 2-week free trial and $25 credit by visiting sanebox.com/keepproductive today. That's sanebox.com/keepproductive. I really hope you enjoy this one, guys. Happy emailing.
So guys, as you can see here, I haven't created a space here yet. I went about deleting the previous ones I created. So I'm creating a space for YouTube videos. So I'm gonna go ahead and press that one there. But what you can do is actually use a template. So for example, if you've got spaces you've created. So let's see if this one works out more suitably. If I press save, you can see, there we go. That YouTube does appear there. And let's say I just wanna, I can add a cup of tea there. And that actually, so here we go. You can also add a space color or avatar. In this case, I'm actually gonna upload the YouTube logo because this might be a little bit more effective to be able to upload something that looks a little bit cleaner. So if I went and found the YouTube logo, okay, there we go. And I pressed save on that one. You can see that the logo comes through here and you can obviously add a color and an icon if you wanted to too. So I can see this is private just to myself. You can add people as well if you had more people there. You could share it with the entire workspace so anyone that has access, so for example, guests can be added there. So I can create these different types of task statuses to get started. So for example, I could follow like the Scrum ruling of how Scrum and Agile teams do that. I could, there we go, use the content one, which I probably will actually use, which means that I can start utilizing one of the templates there. If I go to new template, I can obviously create new statuses. And if I want to, I can modify the existing one, which is very useful, and save it. You can create custom ones or follow like a Kanban traditional experience. Now you can enable what's called ClickUp apps. This is the same as what was previously available. In this case, I might want to have time tracking on. Priority could be important. Tags, yep. Time estimates, if you wanted them, custom fields, I might remove this. Actually, I'll keep this one to show you guys. And you can have dependency warnings. But in this case, I'm not going to actually have dependency on. So here we go. Here are the required views that you have. So you can have list view always required and board view is always required. I'm going to have calendar view on as well. I'm not going to have box view or Gantt view. Actually, Gantt view is part of the premium. So you can't actually get hold of that one. and the form, maps, files, and dashboard are all coming soon. So let's go ahead and review my new space. So you can see here all of the information that I added, everything from the space name to the actual specific ClickUp apps that I've created, and it will go ahead and create your new space. So there we go, I've got something to get me started, and something I must say is from the previous ClickUp, you can check out our previous video on there, it does look a lot more attractive. For example, you can go up to inbox here, it's a lot cleaner. It's just a lot easier to navigate as well. On this left-hand panel, this is where you can navigate new spaces, find details there. It just looks like a lot more attractive. Up here, this is where you navigate the different viewing options, but you actually have to create a list to get started. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a new folder, but in this case, I'm gonna create a new list, and I'm gonna call this one YouTube Content Calendar. So here we go. Naturally, this list is using the status inherent to the YouTube video space, which we created. You can actually dismiss that. And I can start adding titles. So I could say, you know, ClickUp 2.0 tour as one of the videos that I'm doing. So obviously in the list view, you get this very basic sort of overview. You can group by different sort of information. So for example, if you've got it based on priority tags, things that we'll run later, you can filter up here and actually filter them down based on the attributes you assign to them. You can also add new tasks up here and add a description. So if I wanted to add a description, I could say, this is for all the upcoming videos on Keep Productive. So that's sort of like a brief explainer here. I've always liked the way that you can open up tasks here, and something I'll show you in a moment anyway. So I've added the title of this, and you can see that the status has already been given there of open. Now, it's very similar to monday.com. You've got what's called groups, so you can collapse groups, you can expand groups, you can add as many tasks as you like. You've also got assignee, so I can actually assign it, obviously in this case it's assigned to myself, but I could hide the column if I wanted to or move it to the end. So I can actually add myself as the assignee. I can give it a due date as well. So for example, I'm like, actually, I want to get this one out by the Tuesday here. What's quite good is you can set it as a recurring one, recurring when it's closed, which is good. And you can actually add a start date and a due date from here. So I'm actually going to start this one today. So I can see a sort of projection of all of the sort of details there. So that's perfect. And I can even set a priority, and I'm going to say this one's just normal right now. So once I'm happy with that, I can press save. And that task is naturally editable, so I can rename it, I can create subtasks for it, I can edit the tags, and it's a weekly tag now. Now this is the sort of task tray that I mentioned before. This hasn't changed since ClickUp 1.0, but it looks great. It always has looked great as a way to manage your tasks. So down here you can obviously add some subtasks, so I could be like create thumbnail, email ClickUp team to check features, and I could individually add the actual dates to them, and I can even add the options. So if I go into options here, I can convert it to a task, actually make that into a task, add a dependency to it, merge it with another task, set a date and a priority which I wanted to do. So I could say tomorrow I will then email the ClickUp team about that. I can add attachments down here. If I wanted to, I can add a checklist, which is very helpful in case I wanted to go through some stuff. I could print, I could see the task history, and I can open this one as a full screen, and I can minimize it down in the corner. So down here, I can actually see the task tray. I can see, okay, this is the task. This is all the details about that. And I can even move the task up here. So I can minimize tasks, which makes them handy to be able to come back for later, and I can even add tasks down here. I can add what's called a reminder and a notepad. A notepad is a separate sort of application that is an addition to your experience. So let me add a few more. Let's say I've also got Notion instead of video, and also I have a superhuman interview planned. So I'm gonna add that there. And pressing enter just get some started. I could say, okay, that's due tomorrow. Okay, that's due next Wednesday. And I can add a priorities here. So I could say low, and they're all assigned to myself, which is perfect. So what's cool is here, this is where the filtering can work. So I can filter down tasks based on priority. I could say I want to only see high importance, and you can do the and or raw setups, which is great. I can even remove that filter if I wanted to. I can group by status. So for example, I'm like, okay, I want to see everything groups of by priority. So that's quite handy. And you can even have subtasks expanded or not. And status is viewed there. Now, one thing I want to reiterate is down here, you can see if I go to the upgrade area, you can see that I'm actually on the free plan. This is me, 100 megabytes, unlimited tasks, unlimited users. And that's quite good, I think. Like, obviously, inside of the premium, you get much more. But I'm on free still. Like, that's really good for a way to be able to manage projects and tasks. Now, let's go to the different views. Let's go to the board view up here. And as you can see, these are the statuses, the active statuses that they set you up with getting started. So I could be like, okay, I am ready to roll. I could say the ClickUp tour is ready. I could say the Notion instead of is being written. And I'm waiting for approval on the superhuman video. So if I go back to the list view, you can see that this has all been now sorted into different areas. So this is perfect. This is a neat way to be able to organize the different statuses of my tasks. And I can go in and be able to modify all of that. So the good thing is up here, something I didn't mention is you've got me mode. So you can only see where things are assigned to you only. And if you want to choose certain people, you can customize it. And what everyone else sees. So that's just something that is sort of a little bit of an add-on. I'll come to the feature side of stuff nearer the end. So as you can see here, I can go in and modify it like I was before, which is really handy. Obviously the status changes up here. And I can move it to the different statuses. So you may have just seen that one move, but you can see that as you drag stuff across, like this is ready to publish, and the closed goes to here. So that essentially means the task is done. I can close the task manually if I want to. And if I go back to list, it disappears from this area. And I can go over here and press show closed, but this means it just disappears automatically from your setup. Okay, so you're probably wondering, how does the calendar view work as well? So I go over to calendar view, and I can see these tasks laid out. So when I mentioned that the ClickUp will be done over the next 5 days, then you can see here that that spans across that. So that's really handy when it comes to being able to see when your tasks are. And obviously, if you've got the Pro, you can see the Gantt view. But the nice thing I like is that you've got week view as well. So you can see the actual days that you've committed to. You've got 4-day view, so you can be a bit more granular. And if you want to, you can add a little task to an actual today. So for example, I could see, you know, film Notion course module 4, and I can press save there. So the task gets added and I can go in and add all the details. So that's one of the things that I know a lot of people like inside of the calendar view. Now up here, you can add more views, and obviously you can add conversations, documents, embeds. But one of the things that I want to be clear is the box and the Gantt are pro features. So just be aware of that. But obviously they look really good. And I'll probably do a separate video on the premium side of stuff to give you a bit of an idea of how and whether it's worth it to go across. Now, one of the things you can do is add a doc view. So you can actually add documents here. So if you and your team want, I guess, like an internal wiki sort of thing, then you can add documents there. You can add conversations as well. So you can start a conversation with your team, and naturally once they're invited to this area, they can obviously see all the details. If I go to list information, they can naturally see the project progress. In this case, there's no set date, so I don't actually have to add any date to it, but I can actually add owners and people that I want invited to these different spaces. Now, if I go to the inbox view, you can see that everything comes in. And I can see, okay, what's in my inbox? What do we need to start today? And I could go, okay, I did that one. Boom. And it gives me what status I need. So in this case, I closed that one, which is perfect. And I can go up to next. I can say, okay, what have I got to do next? Ah, I've got this one to approve. So I can go, actually it's in the publish phase now. It's still, you know, set for tomorrow, but it gives me a bit of an update on what's going on. And I can also see what has been done as well, what's been delegated to other people, and what is unscheduled out of the stuff I've done. I've also got notifications of when things have been cleared. That's useful for when your teams. But here I've also got the way to see everything as spaces. So I can see all of the lists I've got, all of the documents that I've got active as well. And down here in the left-hand corner, I've got goals. So I can set goals inside of my account, which is quite cool. Something I didn't actually know you could do inside of your ClickUp account. You've also got portfolios as well to see a high-level view of only lists you care about. Now, I actually don't know whether that's a premium feature. I will touch on that in the sort of bigger deep dive. And you've also got reporting as well. So reporting is something that you can see anything from what's been completed, but in the unlimited plan, you can see what's been worked on, who's behind it, time track so far. And down here, you can see all of the sort of preferences, settings that you do have for your ClickUp account. Now, obviously, I keep mentioning this is, so monthly it's $9 per month per user. You get unlimited storage, all the reporting, Google Drive and Dropbox, unlimited custom fields, goals and portfolios, there we go. Set permissions, guest visibility, unlimited views, and delegating Gantt and Box, 5 guests and 2 per extra seat. And you can also see that in the free plan, it gives you pretty much something to get you started. So guys, that was ClickUp 2.0. It hasn't really changed too much. What I would say is it's just, a little bit more refined. I really like the design. Like, there's something that's, I think, definitely improved in this account. And I think they've really honed in on some features. They just look more cleaner, more smarter. I always try and recommend this where I can, because, for example, if someone emails me and says, I need this as a specific way to manage, this is quite a good general application if you're looking for something that I guess takes Asana a little further, but isn't necessarily like the workflow ability of, say, monday.com or other applications like that, then this is a good middle ground. This is a really reliable sort of broad application. Now, one thing I want to mention is I will be doing more videos on this, probably trying to bring in other people to talk through this application further. I'm not an active user, but this is something that I know a lot of people want to learn more about. Anyway, guys, a big thank you. A big thanks again for stopping by. If you're not subscribed yet, hit subscribe, and I will talk to you guys super duper soon. Thank you very much, and I'll see you all very soon. Cheers, everyone.